While Constantinople was famous for its strategic location, the triangular peninsula of the city lacked sufficient fresh water. Aqueducts were absolutely essential to Constantinople, as it only had a single stream, a few small springs, and long dry summers. An extensive aqueduct system was built in late antiquity to help supply water to the growing population of the city. The most famous monument of this system is the Aqueduct Bridge of Valens, completed by Emperor Valens perhaps around 372. He was celebrated for bringing Thracian nymphs to the city, which was said to be dying of thirst. The aqueduct system of Valens was also expanded during the 5th century, during the Theodosian era. This was the second aqueduct system of the city, as Hadrian had built one for Byzantium a couple centuries earlier. The aqueduct of Valens, which stretches across the valley between the 4th and 3rd hills of the city, consists of a bridge of 86 arches. It is over 970 meters long, with a maximum height of around 28 meters. The aqueduct of Valens brought water from several streams in the Thracian hinterland, from almost 130 kilometers away. It consisted of a network of channels that was almost 500 kilometers long, making it the longest Roman aqueduct system. Just as in other Roman cities, Constantinople's aqueducts involved a gravity-based system of channels and bridges. While bridges of arches are the most famous feature of Roman aqueducts, most of the water ran in underground channels. Typically, the gradient of Roman aqueduct channels was around 1 to 1,000. In other words, it used gravity by having the channels drop around 1 meter for every 1,000 meters. Bridges of arches were only used to cross valleys. The Aqueduct of Valens terminated at Binbir Direk's cistern, which functioned as a distribution center, supplying fountains, baths, and other buildings in the Great Palace region. While cisterns could be found throughout the Roman world, cisterns were built in Constantinople on an unprecedented scale, becoming a central feature of its water supply system. Over 150 cisterns have been documented, but likely a significant amount were also lost. They were essential for storing water during the long dry summers, as well as potential sieges of the city. Even as the aqueduct lines fell into disrepair, cisterns continued to be built to collect rainwater until the end of the empire.